إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله. أما بعد، أيها الأحبة في الله، السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته مع درس ماتع. أسأل الله سبحانه وتعالى أن يبارك لنا في وقتنا وأن يبارك لنا في علمنا وفي فهمنا وفي حياتنا جميعا، آمين يا رب العالمين. معلوم أن الحياة الزوجية تقوم على التفاهم والمحبة والتراضي حتى في أوقات الغضب. We know that, brothers and sisters, that marital life between husband and wife, the relationship should be established based on love and understanding, compassion, and even in times of discourse or times of misunderstanding or anger. This is how it's supposed to be. لذلك درس اليوم بعنوان اجعل غضبك على زوجك لله. Our topic today is how to make your anger on your spouse for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We know that when it comes to the husband or to men in general, very seldom they talk about love in the sense of I love you and such. It's even hard for them to say it. Even if they say it, the wife is not going to believe it, especially when they know that the husband can lie to his wife in these matters. The thing that they don't know, or even that the wives don't know, that they can do the same thing. It's not only men who can do that. يعني الرجل عادة في أمور الحب والعلاقات الزوجية يصعب أن يتلفظ بكلمة أحبك لزوجته، وقد لا يقولها، ولكن إذا أحب أعطى. Husband, even though he doesn't do all of this, but when he loves, he gives. When he loves, he gives. That's why a lot of men say, I believe in action, not just in words. لذلك الرجل يعني أو غالب الرجال يقولون أنا ما بقول، أنا رجل بعمل. طيب كذلك المرأة يعني حقائق أنها تتكلم أكثر بالحب وتقول لزوجها مثلا أنا بحبك، والبعض يقول بموت فيك. هم مش عارفين طبعا أنه في هذا الكلام هي جعلت زوجها كالقبر، بموت فيك، يعني الزوج قبر وهي تموت هناك. طبعا مش هذا المقصد. Women, on the other hand, they don't mind. In fact, they do say, I love you, to the husband. In fact, some of them in Arabic, they say, I die, it's supposed to be for you, but they say it, if you translate it literally, I die in you, as if the husband is the grave and they will die there. So this is linguistically in Arabic, if you say it, it could mean that, but that's not exactly what they mean. So how do you do it? How do you make your anger for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and your spouse? And of course, men are smiling right now. Probably they think that the talk is directed to them. Rather, it's directed for the husband and for the wife equally. make your anger for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. هذا الكلام مش موجه فقط للرجال قد يعتقدوا ذلك، لكن الكلام موجه للزوج وللزوجة على سواء. اجعل غضبك لله، يعني عندما تقصر الزوجة في أمر ما أو يقصر الزوج في أمر ما، لا تغضب على الفعل أو عدم الفعل. When the husband or the wife falls short in fulfilling an obligation or doing something or not doing something, doing something that you don't like or not doing something you like, don't get angry for that particular thing. ولكن اجعل غضبك لله. تذكر أنها قصرت في أمر شرعي، يعني مثلا كانت حريصة على قراءة القرآن وتوقفت، أو كانت تقوم من الليل وتوقفت، أو كانت لا تكثر من الاستغابة وتوقفت، أو كان اللبس يعني محتشم وقل ذلك وما إلى ذلك. يعني look at your wife or your husband, and let's say that your wife used to do قيام الليل and she doesn't do it as often. She used to read a page of Quran every day or more, and now she doesn't. Or she used to wear very modestly, but now she doesn't. So get your anger on that particular topic, but don't do it immediately because she will catch it, or she might catch it. Pause for a minute, act nothing is going on, and then say, you know, you used to read Quran every day. What's wrong? What happened? Why you're not reading Quran? No faith anymore? What happened to your faith? What happened to your religion? You just sold it? You just gave it up? Something like that. بتفش غلك هيك. يعني you relieve yourself with something she cannot hold badly against you. She might get angry, but not for long, because she doesn't take it personal. يعني ممكن الزوجة تغضب أو الزوج يغضب، ولكن مش غضب طويل ولا غضب كبير، لأنه أو لأنها تعتقد أن فعلك هذا في سبيل الله وليس على تقصيرها، لأنك لم تذكر شيئا من التقصير. The wife would think, or the husband would think, that you're really sincere. You're talking for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It's not for their shortcoming, because you did not even bring it up. هكذا بهذه الطريقة تكسب زوجتك، والزوجة تكسب زوجها، بل ويكبر في عينها. This way, not only you save your relationships, but you gain the love and the trust of your wife or your husband, and you become great. MashaAllah. We know الرسول صلى الله عليه وسلم كان لا يغضب لنفسه، كان يغضب لله. إذا انتهكت محارم الله سبحانه وتعالى احمر وجهه صلى الله عليه وسلم، علامة الغضب. We know that Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم, as Aisha رضي الله عنها said, that he used to not get angry for himself. He used to get angry for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. His face becomes red, and that is the sign of anger. So the wife or the husband would think, MashaAllah, you know, my husband is following really the sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. I know some of you probably think, well, this is hypocrisy, he's lying. This is hypocrisy. يعني البعض ممكن يقول هذا نفاق، هو بيكذب أو هي بتكذب. لا، بين الزوجين لا ضرر في هذه الأمور إن كان الهدف هو إصلاح المشاكل ويعني توطيد المحبة بين الزوجين. When it comes to this between husband and wife, there is no haram in that. As long as the intention is to strengthen the relationship between you and your wife and to save your marriage and to avoid problems and harm to one another. So, كون ذكي كزوج وكوني ذكية كزوجة. اغضبي لله مع زوجك أو اغضب لله مع زوجتك. So we need to be smart and intelligent when we get angry with our spouse. We need to make it for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And that way we both look good, inshallah. But be intelligent and smart to know when and how to do it, and with something real that they used to do and they are not doing. Don't just pick up something random and they don't know or they have no idea what you're talking about. Be intelligent in both ways, how to do it and for what to do it. Do it for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and do it right, and inshallah you will have a wonderful marriage and you will be more loved. You strengthen the love between you and your spouse. As-salamu Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala أن ينفعنا وإياكم ويجعلنا من الذين يستمعون القول فيتبعون أحسنه. I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to help us strengthen those relationships, because Shaitan loves discord between husband and wife, and Shaitan loves divorce. You want to stay as far as you can from thinking of divorce, not uttering like some people utter divorce, say divorce at every time of anger. Avoid all of that. Know that Shaitan loves that the most after shirk. So be careful. Don't do the things that Shaitan loves. Use it in an intelligent way and for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Jazakumullahu khairan. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.